to my channel. My name is Caitlin if you are new here. So today I am in a brand new space. I am in my office. If you haven't already seen my stationery video of how I set up everything that I use for my bullet journal as well as every other craft that I have, I'll link that up above for you guys as well in the description box down below. But today I'm going to be showing you how to bullet journal as a student. This is my favorite kind of videos. I started bullet journaling as a student and absolutely recommend if you are a student, grab yourself a bullet journal. So today I'm going to really be showing you how to get productive. So increase your productivity as a student, all of that jazz with some spreads for you today, and make sure to stay tuned to the very end where I might shout out to you. All right, I'll hop right on into the video. So you might be thinking, okay, Caitlin, how many student bullet journal videos can you create? And let's just say I got a lot because I did use a lot of stuff when I was at school myself. And the first thing that I always thought of was I need to come up with a goal. And that is just the cover page or a quote or whatever you'd like to call it that I put down on this side, just as a little decorative piece because I did use my bullet journal in school as a place where I could express my creativity but also keep me productive. Productive and organized. So here I wrote out goal and the definition. I did end up making a little bit of a spelling mistake, so I came over top here just with a black pen and covered up the word, but then also added some other black spots to make it look a little bit more cohesive. That is a really good trick if you ever find yourself in a position where you've made a little bit of a mistake and you might need to fix it up. I really do love having a quote, but something instead, if you wanted to make this a little bit more productive, is you could bump up the word goal and have your goals for the semester, for the week, for whatever class you're in, and then write down different ideas and different points of exactly how you want to accomplish those goals. So if you want to get 100% in participation, well, what does that look like? For me, going to class every week and raising my hand once. That's some way that you could maybe increase the chances that you're going to get a high grade in participation. Now, it wouldn't really be a journal of mine as a student without a timetable. But I've done timetables in the past, so I wanted to show you guys something a little different with sticky notes. That is where this little timetable comes into play. So I am just penciling off different sections of the sticky notes so I can get the right size. But basically what this is gonna do is you're gonna cut it down to the hour that you want it. So I'm gonna put this for 2 hours. And then on the sticky note, you're gonna write whatever task you need. So for me, I just did the example of meal prep and I put it down at a time where I would usually meal prep. My schedule is planted in there already and you can see it blocked off just with those gray markers, but you could actually put them in if you wanted. And then the sticky notes are able to move around. So the part-time job that I have here, I have two, let's say, shifts a week and they alter different times. Let's say you're working at McDonald's. I was a Timmy's girl. So the hours aren't really consistent some weeks, but once you have in things like extracurriculars, your job, meal prepping, any kind of other things, you can begin to adjust the schedule. And that's what I did when I had a group project, for example, on Monday. My meal prep time is gonna change. So I just shifted it around to where there was a 2-hour block, because that's how I know long meal prep takes me. Just to finish this off, I ended up putting in the timetable at the top, but this is so versatile. You're able to just set it up once and move things around. And as a student, you wanna make the most of your time, and this is really gonna help increase your productivity. You can use this as a weekly thing, as a monthly. You could even put in things like sticky notes for study times as well. Those are just a couple other ideas for you. Continuing on the classics I like to make sure that I have is an assignment tracker. So I'm going to be setting up this thing called a Kangen board. And if you haven't heard about it before, I originally saw this from another YouTuber called The Plant-Based Bride, and she uses it for organizing her videos. I thought it would be perfect if you included something like this for your assignments. Basically how you do it is you fill out certain sections. So I blocked off 8 sections here, and on the side I've wrote things down like print off and read the assignment, make the outline, research topics, rough draft, peer review, edit my notes, final review, and then submit. These are going to be all of the steps that I follow generally for the majority of the projects that I do, whether it be a research-based paper. I was in math and business, so we had to do a lot of caseworks as well. And then you write down on a colored sticky note, you could color coordinate if you want. I am a sucker for that. Just the topic or the due date. Then you can move the sticky notes along each of those rows depending upon what spot you are in the assignment. So if let's say the due date for the blue one comes sooner than all of the other ones, I would end up putting it down at the bottom and focus on it a lot quicker than all of my other ones. But it gives you a quick visual on where things are at, and you only have to set it up once. Something else that I have shown you guys in one of the previous set up your student bullet journal videos is a study log. And this is kind of similar to what a study log looks like in the past. However, it is based on the number of hours that you do per class. I think it is really important to track where your time goes as a student, because then you're gonna know, when did I do studying last for a class? And when do I really need to focus in on something? Maybe an exam's coming up and I really need to put a couple of hours of one certain class, or I have an in-class test or something like that. No matter if you are in university or high school, it's really good to track your productivity. So I've color-coded the top section here, and you could put things in like extracurriculars, you could put things in like your job. I just put in different class examples, and then you end up coloring in how many hours you did. So on that first day, Wednesday, I just plopped in three different things. I had two of class F and one of class C, and then I just keep going down every single day, and I try to focus my time particularly on different classes on different dates. That's a way I know that I'm getting a well-rounded study time, and that's really important for me personally, but of course you guys can always do what works best for you as a student. Now, you can't know where you're going without actually knowing where you've been. I know it's super classic saying, but it's honestly true. So I've left this space here for a weekly reflection, and it's really gonna tell you exactly what you need to focus in on during the week, what challenges are gonna be coming up, what successes you think you had, and then next week. So the top section is really a pre-reflection, and then the bottom section is really a post-reflection. So if I have, let's say, a test coming up, or a group project or something like that in the next couple weeks, maybe my top tasks are doing something with that. So researching or getting together and connected with my group. Some of the challenges that I might face, well, I have a group of six and it's not always easy getting people together. And then at the end of the week, I go through my successes and what's up for next week and maybe things I wanna look at. On the next and last productivity tracker for students is a to-do list. So you only got a few minutes to spare, and that is really important when you are a student of making the most of those times. I've wrote down different things that you can do during those small breaks. In that 5-minute interval, you can do things like a learning objectives. I like to write my learning objectives down each chapter. You could read some emails, book a study room, or download some music to listen to when you are studying. And then I go through each of those for 10 minutes, 20 minutes, and 40 minutes. So if you're in between classes, or you have a little lunch break, or you're usually just sitting and waiting for the teacher or the professor to start, you can do a whole bunch of stuff. So things like read an assignment, meal prep, do a weekly reflection, do a couple chapter pages, and it'll depend based on what grade you're in and what your goals are for each semester. Here is just a quick flip through of what we did today together, and let me know down in the comments below what tracker you liked the best and what ones you end up using in your student bullet journal as well. Well, that's it. I hope you enjoyed today's video. Thank you to Tweetums for leaving a lovely comment down below. I'm glad you found last week's tips very helpful. And if you would like a shout out as well, make sure to smash that like button, hit the subscribe button, and comment down below. It really does help support my channel to grow, and we'll see you next week. Bye guys!